The Omaha police contract clears a decisive hurdle with city leaders, and they take some verbal jabs in the process.
Because it's almost like you're trying to be personally contentious with me over this.
No, not necessarily. Because I'm just
giving
to
you
get
information
some
you don't want to hear.
That's all.
Good evening. I'm Brandi Peterson. Rob McCartney has the night off. Anger and opposition won't go away, but Omaha's personnel board today signed off on the proposed contract between the city and the police union. KETV Newswatch 7's Melissa Fry is live at 6 with our big story.
Well, with the personnel board voting in favor of the contract, the city council will need just 4 votes to pass, not 5. But remember, the personnel board approved the last contract, and that one the council threw out. So it's not a done deal yet. A battle over numbers and a record budget shortfall.
I will bet you a box of 24 donuts.
As the revised police union contract came before the personnel board, there was Dave Nabody and his Omaha Alliance for the Private Sector. He argued Omaha is spending 13 times what comparable cities spend on police pensions, and that lit a fuse.
You don't know the entire universe of what all those other cities are possibly doing at this particular moment. No.
Okay.
And so
this
all
is
I am
my...
asking is that you remain consistent in the information that you're presenting.
This is precisely why I said that your body needs to take its time and do its due diligence. How could you possibly pass a contract through if you don't know the answers to these questions?
Because
it's almost like you're trying to be personally contentious with me over
not
this.
Not necessarily.
Because
I'm just
giving
trying
you
to get
information
some
you don't want to hear.
That's all.
In the end, the personnel board signed on to the tentative contract, but it will take 4 votes from the city council to approve it. And even then, nearly half a century to dig Omaha out of a pension deficit.
Well, when you're looking at something that's going to take 45 years to come out whole, I think this is just the beginning of trying to fix the problem we're in today. I'm sure there's going to be a lot more changes before this thing's resolved.
Under the deal, Omaha will spend $15 million per year by 2015 on police pensions. The practice of spiking pensions with increased overtime would be eliminated. And the average officer would pay an additional $1,300 per year on his or her pensions. It may be a deal that pleases no one.
They're just as frustrated that they have to reduce their pension benefits and pay more money when times are tight to pay off the poor decisions.
Again, with the city personnel board approving the police pension, the city council needs 4 votes to pass the contract. I've tried to make contact with all of the city council members. Pete Festerson tells me the contract is too long and too expensive, so he's leaning towards not voting for it. Councilman Gary Gurnett says he is leaning towards supporting the plan.
Melissa, with Gurnett being a retired police officer himself, can he vote?
Well, he says that the city legal department says yes, but he is waiting to hear from the State Accountability Disclosure Commission.
All right, Melissa Fry, thank you. The city says it is ready to answer your questions about the proposed police contract. So next week, it will hold 2 public forums. The first, Tuesday, at the Omaha Public Schools Teacher Administration Building at 32nd and Cumming. Then Wednesday at Westside High School. Both meetings are from 6:30 to 8 p.m. Remember, you can log on right now and sound off on KETV.com. You'll find the OPD contract story on our homepage.